Who was Bobby Hutton, and why did his death affect the party so deeply?
Bobby Hutton was the first member of the Black Panther Party. He was recruited at the North Oakland Service Center in October 66. I believe he was 15 at the time. He was our first recruit, and we made him treasurer. And he was like my little brother that I never had. And he was the inspiration of the party, because the party was very youth oriented. And while he worked at the North Oakland Service Center, we tutored him and politicized him. And until he was killed, that I really couldn't imagine, not really imagine, any of our party members being murdered, even though that I knew that that risk took place. I was in the county jail at the time of his murder. This was the day that Martin Luther King was assassinated. And after he was killed, then it was like that I felt that anyone in the party, I felt the party vulnerable. So he was very loved as a youth in the party and as our first member.
Where did you see the Black Panther Party headed by the end of 68? At that point, you're in prison. You've been convicted. Seal is under indictment. Cleaver is out of the country. What did you think? What did you think was going to happen?
Well, again, that I wanted to emphasize the community development aspect of the party. We were, at the time, that we were just creating a, we were planning our creation of a community school. We were having busing programs to prisons where we would pick up community people and take them to the various penal institutions. I felt that we should turn away from the arms, because too much had been made of them, and I thought that the arms had served their purpose as far as being a catalyst to gain enthusiasm of the community.
But what did you think was going to happen? I mean, were you aware that the federal government was on the Panthers' tail at that point?
Oh yeah, I was very well aware of that. Was one of the reasons that we didn't want the during the period of 68-69, the federal government had declared all-out war on the party, and they were breaking into headquarters across the chapters, breaking into chapter headquarters across the country, and filming weapons and saying that, look, they have guns. It was never mentioned that the guns were legal weapons. They were doing everything to make the community afraid of the party. And of course, you can't organize when people are afraid of you. So I was inclined to try to develop more local politics, to run local members for various offices, and develop our 10-point program, which was a housing and food and health program.